Well, in the meantime, hold on tight to your purse when you're out in public because someone might grab it. How old is this? Someone out there has been driving around past women grabbing their purses right off their shoulders. This is a look at the car they believe is used in those crimes. 7 News reporter Lance Hernandez is looking into this. And Lance, you talked to a woman who had her purse stolen, and I bet she is mad.
She's mad, but she's also grateful that she wasn't hurt. Now, this Crime Stoppers bulletin released a little bit earlier today says if you see the suspect driving this car, or I might add an accomplice, don't try to contact him. The victim we talked to said the driver had a gun.
I was walking to the light rail on my way to work, and somebody just got in his car, snatched my purse from my arm. He had a gun in his car.
Last Thursday was one Adriana Lopez will never forget. She said the purse snatcher had a gun in one hand on the steering wheel and that he grabbed her purse with the other.
My impression was not to move or not to do anything just because he was there with his gun.
Police say there have been several similar heists. One woman walking toward a store on South Colorado Boulevard at Iowa when a passenger in a car reached out, grabbed her arm, knocked her to the ground, and grabbed her purse. The car took off. The same thing at a Walmart parking lot in Stapleton. At least 7 purse snatchings in 4 cities. The motive? Robbery.
We have not had any information yet saying that there's been identity theft. Now, not saying that it's not going to happen because it's been, you know what I mean? But we haven't received anything. I don't believe that the victims have received their purses back, though.
This is the Crime Stoppers bulletin released by Arvada Police Department this morning. In all 7 cases, 4 of them in Denver, 1 in Arvada, 1 in Inglewood, and at least 1 in Glendale. The suspect who is driving that car, believed to be in his late 20s to early 40s with dark blonde or reddish hair. Again, if you see him, don't contact him. Just call 911. Reporting live in Denver, Lance Hernandez, 7 News.